Welcome to this new picoFlamingo demonstration. This time we are going to show how picoFlamingo can make your slides more interactive. During this short presentation, we are going to use our new Android client that allows us to control the presentation via Bluetooth from our mobile phone. So let's go to the next slide. What do we mean by interactive slides? Basically, we support two kind of interaction with the presentation. The first one is to manipulate these slide items, which actually are 3D objects, in a 3D space during the presentation is going on. We will show an example how this could look like in a way. Additionally, the picoFlamingo remote interface allow us to connect the presentation system to external applications that can improve the interaction capabilities of the system, adding, for example, voice commanding or updating the presentation items according to some external event or stimuli. So let's see how all this interaction concept should work in a real presentation. In this demonstration, we have prepared a slide including a 3D model and also a live video that we will activate in a while. We will be controlling the interaction with the slide using voice commanding with an external application developed using CMU Pocket Sphinx. And this application will send the proper commands to picoFlamingo according to what the user is saying. Additionally, we have modified this tool to support the commanding of the slide using different languages. So let's see how it looks like. Voice commanding on. Camera 1. Spin model. I prefer to speak Spanish.
Cambiando a castellano, espera un momento, por favor.
Ampliar. Ampliar. Reducir. Seleccionar modelo. Seleccionar vídeo. Prefiero hablar gallego.
Cambiando a gallego. Espera un momento, por favor.
Virar modelo. Virar modelo. Seleccionar vídeo. Virar a derecha. Virar a izquierda. Prefiero hablar inglés.
Switching to English. Just a second, please.
Voice commanding off.
Voice commanding deactivated.
So this is our demonstration. Additionally, we can always use the mouse with the presentation and manipulate using the mouse the 3D models in it. So we can rotate it, we can also change the position and even make it bigger or smaller to look into the details of the 3D model. The same we can do with the camera, and that is more intuitive as it is live video, so we can show details of our Android client using the camera and make it easier to show this kind of small things to all the public in a presentation without having to pass to everybody the device you want to show or discuss about it. So this finishes our demonstration. We hope you find it interesting, and many thanks for your attention.